Hi Stampers, this is Diane Cisneros, and today we're going to do Diane Teach Me That. This is Wondrous Wreath, and I wanted to make a fall wreath. The three colors I used were Hello Honey, Blackberry Bliss, and the Mossy Meadow. So I'm going to set this aside, and the first thing we're going to do is use the photopolymer stamps. Where did I put that? I was going to show you the box. These are photopolymer, and I'm using these three rings. So I've gone ahead and put the first one on the block, and I'm going to get my, let's see, my Hello Honey, and I'm going to tap it on there. And they all have a little tab right here, so that this is like three-step stamping, so they're telling you keep your tabs down. Always in the same position, and then you won't have any problem. So I'm going to go ahead and just stamp that, pull it off. Then I'm going to pull my tab and put it over here on my silicone mat. I'm going to pick up the other one. Make sure that little tab is in the down position. Get my Blackberry Bliss. And tap on these leaves here. And make sure the tab's down. And you should be able to see pretty much where this goes, because you can see right through. There you go. That's beautiful. Okay, so you peel that off, put it on your silicone mat, pick up the other one, tab down. And these are the little berries, but in this case, I'm going to do green because I'm doing a fall wreath. And this is Mossy Meadow. Tab down. And there's your green berries or whatever. Okay, so I've showed you how to do that with the tabs, and I don't want to pull my Big Shot in here, so I'm going to put these aside and bring in the framelits. Now these are all on one page. This is the stamp set, Wondrous Wreath right here, and then right above it are the framelits. Wondrous, wonderful wreath, and if you buy them together in a bundle, you get 15% off. So I've gone ahead and run it through the Big Shot already, and I want to show you a little trick with these. So here's my wreath. So here's your little tab at the bottom, and when you put it there, it fits pretty good when you see, there's some long prongs in here, like there's a long prong there and there's a big space here, so I know that goes there. Oops, it's a little sticky. So you just keep turning it until you feel like it's in the right place. And then the center one also has a little tab, also has a kind of an out of the way prong thing there. And there's a big space right there, so I know that goes there. And that's how you'll lay it on your Big Shot. So now we can get busy and make the card. I've got my wreath. And here is my Mossy Meadow paper, and it's cut 4 1/4 by 11, scored at 5 1/2. And then I chose some designer series paper. This is called Color Me Autumn, and it is cut 4 by 5 1/4. My bad, I just went and got my... Okay, and then my Blackberry Bliss banner is cut 1 1/4 by 5, and then I went ahead and used my square punch to make, this is 1 1/4, which is retired, but I kept it, so I like to use them to make the bottom. This is Whisper White, I used the Stylish Stripes folder to give it a little dimension, and I cut this white one. Let's see, this one is 1.5 by 4.75. So now I can put it together. Okay, there's my first layer. And then I'm going to put my Blackberry Bliss. And you can use dimensionals. I think I used dimensionals on the original. But naturally, I didn't bring any, so we won't be doing that. So this pretty much fits right in the center. Then I'm going to take the white one. And just put this down a little bit and over the top. Okay. And this is my banner. I think I'm going to do the thread first. I have a little thread that I want to put on the bottom. And I'm going to show you how to do that. I do have some dimensionals here. I'm holding out of my drawer. So I went ahead and wrapped the linen thread around this piece of scrap paper about 5-6 times. Okay, and then I took a little piece of thread and I'm going to pull this off. Squeeze it in the middle, kind of twist it. I'm going to take my separate piece of thread and just tie a knot. I had a friend tell me, I think it was Crafty Chic. She's always watching. I don't know why you're so nervous. You do a good job. Well, I'm not nervous. I'm old. Old people shake. Goodness gracious. I'm 69. I think that's old, but I don't feel old. Anyway, I'm not nervous. Don't feel sorry for me. Okay, so I'm going to clip these off. And then I'm going to take them and open them. Don't worry about which way they go. They're going to go fine when you put them down. It's kind of the new thing everybody's doing. Now, I've used so much of this, now I've got to order some more. I mean, I've used it on a lot of cards. I like it. Okay, now I don't like that one, so I'm going to take that one out, and this one out. Okay, now the center is not going to show, so we're not going to worry about that. I'm going to take a dimensional. I would rather use a glue dot, but again, I don't have those either. I mean, I don't have them here. So I want this right about there, and I'm going to put that twine or thread right there, so it'll show. Then I'm going to go ahead and put some dimensionals at the top and at the bottom. I'm not going to put too many dimensionals on here right now because I put too many on the other one and it's just doesn't lay straight for me. So I got one here See this one underneath? And there's one here, so that means I need two. So they'll be even. They'll stand up the same. So here's my one. And there's my two up there. And we'll pull some of these down so you can see them. I've got one sticking out. I don't like it. Okay. There. I'm going to push this one a little tighter. Okay. Now, part of the framelits, they did have a little bow. So I'm going to punch that out. I did it in Blackberry Bliss. And I think I'm just going to put a little adhesive on this. Because I don't want it raised up. And then I have some candy dots, and they are not honey. Hello, honey. I would think this would be crushed curry, but that's okay. All right, and then I have, what do I have? I have a little verse, and that this verse came from this set, For All Things. It just says, Hello Fall, and I've already put it through the Big Shot. Couple more dimensionals. And then I'm going to slide this. Whoops, let's take this off. I'm going to push those up for now so I can get this right where I want it. Ugh. There. Okay, I'm going to pull those back down. Oh my gosh, I love it. There it is. So now we have two beautiful cards. And it wasn't too bad. I hope this video will help you when you get your photopolymer. You have to practice doing this. I had to do it 2 or 3 times to get the right amount of push to get a good even color all the way around, and then try to get the two-step stamping business going on so that it falls kind of where it's supposed to. But you can do it, and you will love it. And I hope that you will tune in again, and I will see you soon.